Greenpoint Williamsburg Public Affairs presentation. This is Neighborhoods Today.
From the little studio on Frost Street, it's the New York Variety Show. And now, look sharp, here's the dear boy himself, Nick Cirillo.
Thank you. Thank you. Obviously, I'm not Nick Cirillo. I'm Dr. Acula. Nick Cirillo has asked me to host this year's Halloween show, which are going to show Halloween from way, way back when, back in the 60s. Now, it's, I think Nick Cirillo used to do jokes. Mr. Producer, is that correct?
Yes, he did.
Look at this, what I picked out of my pockets. Jokes.
I hope you have some good ones for us.
Well, we'll certainly find out
now. Because some of Nick's jokes weren't the best.
Okay. First joke, what is a mummy's favorite type of music?
Mummified?
No, a rap. You know, rap.
Rap?
Rap music, rap. Mummies are rap, aren't they?
Yes.
Well, that's what it is, rap.
Okay.
Okay. What do goblins and ghosts drink when they are hot and thirsty on Halloween?
A cool fizz?
No, Kool-Aid.
Kool-Aid.
Kool-Aid, you know, like ghouls?
Yes,
aid? You know, like the other aid?
Yes, I don't
Kool-Aid,
know if working
Kool-Aid.
With you or working with Nick Cirillo was the worst, but okay.
Oh, nice. Joke number three. What do you call a witch who lives at the beach?
A witch hunter.
No, or a sandwich. Don't you get it? He's a witch on the beach.
Okay, I get it, I get it.
Oh, boy, you're really slow today there. You're James, right?
Yes, I'm James.
Oh, I thought so, yes. What do the skeletons say to the vampire?
What does a skeleton say to a vampire?
Yeah, what does he say? Come on, you know.
Boo.
No, he goes, you suck.
What?
The vampire sucks blood, right?
Yes.
So, the skeleton says to the vampire, what he does, you suck. I think you're very slow today. Okay.
I think Nick Cirillo might have been better than you. Maybe we better get the big hook out.
Okay. Where does Count Dracula usually eat his lunch?
In a coffin.
No! At the cascateria.
Well, that was pretty good. I think
you
I like
that
one.
You like that
one,
huh?
Yeah, I like that one.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah, not bad. Why did the skeleton dance at the party?
Why did the skeleton dance at the party?
Why didn't he dance?
He had nobody to dance with.
That's correct. You did it. 5 points for you. And the last joke. What happens when two vampires meet?
When two vampires meet, they disappear.
No, it was love at the first bite. Well, at least you got one joke out of all these seven.
I don't know. Where do you get these jokes from? The same place
I don't
that
know
Mr.
either.
Cirillo
you
does?
Got to ask yourself. You're the one that provided them for me. Now, we are going to go and check out a little later when I get back into the studio, which I was big thing for me because I usually do this from the basement, but I got promoted up to the studio this year.
I know, Doctor. I have never seen you in the studio before.
Well, you will see me now, okay?
Okay, are we going to 1969?
That's correct.
For the New York Variety Show?
New York Variety Show.
Okay.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, let's take it away.
Here I am, exactly on the actual set of the New York Variety Show. It's so glad to be up here. It's much different than being down in the basement all the time. I'm very pleased to be here in place of Nick Cirillo. And of course, I'm always here with my dear friend and colleague, Mr. Bonesy, Seymour T. Bones. Yes,
he's Doctor. Doctor.
Yes, Seymour.
What are we doing in this studio?
Well, this is something new now. I'm going to be here for the Halloween show this year. We are going to be showing Halloween shows from back in 1969.
I don't think I like it here.
Why not?
I like the dungeon. It's more homey.
Oh, I'll make it more homey for you. I provide you some smoke. You like smoke?
Yes, I see the fog setting in now.
Yes, you like that feel? Makes you feel better?
Yes, okay.
Oh, that's good.
That's a little better.
Okay, I'm glad. Now we are going to go to see the Hot Mamas Uppies Band, done way back in 1969, hosted by Smiling Jack. So here we go.
We're going to have the Hot Mamas Uppies Band. Quiet, quiet, quiet. I'll introduce you in a minute. The Hot Mommy's Uppies Band is going to sing Fire. Here we have that great, renowned group, the Hot Mommy's Uppies Band. Take it away. Mommy's Uppies Band, and let's have your names.
Hot Mama.
Freezing Sun.
Hot Daughter.
Warm Daughter, still a bit.
Warm Daughter.
Cold Papa.
Now that you have your name straight, where have you been playing and what have you been doing recently?
Playing at the Stevo Cuckoo.
Are they the only ones that hire you?
Alice's restaurant.
How's the food over there?
They sell good meatballs.
And ravioli.
And googles. Don't forget googles. We'll be right back in a moment.
Yes, sirree. What did you think of that band there, Bonesy? The Hot Mama's Uppies band. Did you like them?
No, I don't know if I particularly cared for them, Doctor.
Why not?
I don't know. Some of them looked a little spooky.
Oh, well, that's what they're supposed to be. It's a Halloween, you know?
Oh, that's right. I kind of lost my mind there for a moment.
Yes, that's too much studying there for being the Doctor of the Dead.
I know.
Yes.
What is this globe that you have sitting in front of me, Doctor?
Oh, this shows us into the future and into the past. Why, we're going to do an apple dunking contest way back when, back in 1969 again, with Michelle, Paulette, and Barbara. Do you want to see that?
Yes. Bonesy? Yes, I'd like to see them apple dunking. I love apple pie.
Now we're going to go back to see the apple dunking contest. So here we go.
Okay.
Next, we're going to have a very interesting contest of apple dunking. Now, we need the people for this great performance.
Apple dunking is much more interesting.
Okay. Come step in.
This is WBCF Television in New York City.
Hey, we are back. So, Bowensy, did you like the apple dunking contest?
Yes, I did, but I would like to have some apple pie.
Well, maybe after the show we'll get some. But you know who won that apple dunking contest now? Michelle. Michelle Rose won the apple dunking contest.
Oh, did she?
Yes, she did. She was very, very good
really
at it.
Oh, I couldn't really tell.
Loved to bite them apples. That's
I was
right.
paying
yes.
more attention to the apples than to the contestants.
Yes, well, now, Bonesy, we're going to have a very, very good segment here coming up. It's Count and Igor, and they're going to be fooling around with an amoeba. You remember amoebas, don't you?
Oh, yes, we've had plenty of them on our own shows.
That's correct. And, well, here's one of the old-timers doing the old thing with the amoeba. So here we go now, the Count and Igor with the experiment of the amoeba.
Hi, and welcome back. Right now, we're in a mad scientist laboratory, and my audience is going to witness a little performance over here. And my two guests right now are Count Fauntleroy and his able assistant, Igor. Here they are.
Bloogie, blooga! Hello, Barbara. It's been so nice to see you again.
Hello, Count.
How are you? I'm going to bite you in the neck. No, I'll do that later. Oh, I want to bring out my able assistant, Igor. Igor!
What?
Come out here.
I was just making my coffin and you had to come up to bother me.
Oh, well.
What do you want?
Louis, my teeth seem to get stuck in my mouth or something.
I now, Count.
I want to show you tonight my amoeba that I brought.
What are you going to do for us tonight, Count?
We're going to operate on the amoeba.
On the amoeba.
I will show you the whole thing if what? You let me. Can I show you?
Sure, go right ahead.
Oh, well.
If I bleed tonight.
Sure. All right.
Okay, Count, let's go.
Here's the amoeba, right here.
That's an amoeba.
This is the amoeba.
Oh, that's the amoeba.
What is that red jelly substance on the top there?
That is the amoeba skin. Oh, the amoeba is running away. Igor, be careful there.
Oh.
Now, we are going to show you tonight how the amoeba reproduces itself. Igor, let's operate on this amoeba.
That reproduces?
Wait a minute, we have to get... Oh, bleeds. I know it does. Wait a minute. I see something very interesting. You just cut my finger. I see something very interesting.
What body did that come from?
Where did that? Oh, here. The very
interesting. Nobody answered my question.
Very
it's
interesting.
The heart. I know.
No,
the heart
no, no.
Anyway.
This is the,
what's that?
The egg that reproduces in the amoeba. If you look right here.
Is it?
Oh, I don't think it got hard boiled.
Give me.
Did that come from Janis Joplin, maybe?
Oh, there you go. Igor, you've like miscarried the amoeba.
Put it back in.
Igor!
Hey, Count!
Igor!
Yes.
How many operations did you perform like this?
Oh, I do this all the time. This
it's
is the main
transplant.
I'll bite you on the neck.
Bite me on the neck.
I like to bite you on the neck.
How many
times?
Wait a minute. If you notice here, it's like running. It runs a lot.
Telling me it does. Ooh. Looks like an oversized blob.
I will just show it to you here, my hands.
Handsome.
Now, wait a minute. We must reproduce this into half, so we will show you how they like, split in half. Could you see that?
Oh, we could.
Now, Igor, could you see that?
You're
how could you miss it?
Do you want to get a little close? My teeth get stuck in my mouth.
I cut it in half?
Yes. Reproduce this amoeba. And hurry up before we run out of time. Is there anything I need for running out of time?
It's a tough amoeba.
Hey, Count, where did you pick up your assistant?
Well, Igor, he's been with me for 2,000 years. There, you see? Success! The amoeba. Now, this amoeba.
I got one amoeba. He got the other
this
amoeba.
This amoeba is still alive.
Looks like scurve.
I beg
okay.
Your pardon.
I want to thank, the Count and his assistant tonight.
Okay, and we're back. Oh, Bonesy, what did you think about the amoeba experiment there?
Oh, I think that the Count is very good, Doctor.
Oh, he was excellent. He's still around, you know. He's still kicking. He may make an appearance on the show one of these days. You don't know.
Oh, that's very good. Very
yes.
Good. But where did that Igor come from?
Oh, Igor. Igor was one of my relatives. Don't you like him?
Well, I don't know. He seemed to get into the Count's way.
Oh, I see. Okay, well, you know what's going to be next?
No, I don't. You have the script, not me.
All right, I'll tell you. The New York Variety Shows has had talent. And we're going to show something a little bit newer right now. We're going to show Busty Springgarten doing Spooky. How would you like that to see that one there,
Jose? Oh, okay. Yes, I'm very interested in that.
Okay, so here we go with Busty Springgarden singing "A Spooky Little Boy Like You." Back and boy, Busty lift us some smoke. She's a hot little one, right? Don't you think so there, Bonesy?
Oh, yeah. I love her dance.
Oh, she was like sexy.
Yeah, and doctor, I think she was looking after you. Maybe you could get a date after the program.
I was making eyes at her while she was doing it.
Well, okay, I think it's time to move on, Doctor.
Okay, now the next thing, we're going to go back to 1969, and the nose-pushing nut race. Very interesting between Jack and Nicky Pinto. Yes, sirree, and here it is now, the nose-pushing nut race.
Hi, and welcome back.
Hot Mama here.
Well, right now, we have Jack, our host, down on the floor over there with Nicky Pinto, and they're going to do, they're going to have a contest, a peanut contest. So, let's see them. Two nuts.
Your nose is big, you all do it fast. Get there. I'll tell you what, I bet you'll win this. I don't use your bag. It's just your nose. All right, you ready? Say go.
Go. And Jack is winning by a nose.
That's not a nose. That's my fine job.
That's right. It does look more like a banana. Oh, come on. Jack, you just lost.
I tell you his nose was bigger.
How do you like that? With Jack having the bigger nose and Nicky winning, our host the loser.
I plead fast.
Thank you, Nuts. And we'll be right back.
And now we're going to have our bag race. Our contestants are going to go up and down in a hop. And we have two hoppity people doing it.
You can say our names.
And they're going to go up and down. We have Michelle and Barbara. And the two idiots are going to go up and down three times. Now I will keep score. And if they fall, we will laugh. Ah. And if they don't fall, we'll just say, gip, gip, gip. Now I'll sit here. Are you ready, contestants?
Wait. Get the quarter.
Set. Go. And Michelle is in the lead. And Michelle is still in the lead. One. Barbara's in the lead. Michelle's in the lead. Two. Barbara's in the lead. Michelle's in the lead.
Go back that way, all the way.
Come back, Barbara. Barbara wins by a head. Okay. And now we're going to interview our contestants, who are now on the floor. Barbara, how does it feel to be the winner?
Winner!
She said the winner. That was her comment. Now we will get Barbara off the floor.
Wait a minute!
We're going to leave Barbara on the floor. And Michelle, how does it feel to come in second?
Same as it would to come in first.
They had that tight feeling. And we'll be right back in one moment.
This ends our little thing for this year, and I would like to thank Nick Cirillo for allowing me to host the show from the actual studio of the New York Variety Show. Usually we are down in the dungeon, isn't that correct, Bonesy?
Yes, but I can't wait to get back home again, Doctor.
You feel bored homebound there,
yeah,
huh?
I mean, it's too much up here. There's too many lights and cameras and everything.
Look, you got your little friend Ratsy came to visit you.
Oh, and what else is going on?
What?
What else are you doing with that crystal ball?
Oh, well, this is the crystal ball saying that we're going to be leaving now. So, until next time, I'm Dr. Acula, signing off. Happy Halloween!
And I'm Bonesy saying happy Halloween.